Another faceoff win by Pajot. Wingles. Pajot shoots. Letting in the stop. Buck bounces it around in front of that Dallas net. Scores. They find it and bury it. And it is 3-0 Ottawa.
You lose the draw clean, so you're Lindy Ruff. You change the whole line. You get a new centerman out there. And you go, okay, we're going to do this again. And then Eakin just loses the draw again, clean. And this is the Ottawa Senators. And Pajot should have scored on that one right there. Once again, very good traffic in front with Pyatt. Senators doing a real good job of having a guy in front of them all the time. And when Pajot shot that one, I thought that should have been in, but he didn't get it to the corners of the net. He hit him square in the chest. But he gets a fortuitous bounce. He gets the puck back. And this time it finds its way into the back of the net. That's going to be all for Kerry Lehtinen as Antti Niemi is going to come in and replace him. And he is not happy about it. A guy that has been on a bit of a roll, and everyone here is thrilled that he has found his game a little bit, but tonight, not so much as the Senators jump out to a 3-0 lead, and that's a lot of run support for Anderson, who's playing so well right now.
And the faceoff control, McGinn a shot, and Brock McGinn makes it 3-0. Right off the faceoff.
Whoa, what a shot this is by McGinn. I mean, this is under the bar and in the net. And the Carolina Hurricanes are having some kind of fun on the ice. And this one goes under the bar and in. Jordan Binnington looks like he's going to get his first NHL action. And this is not a reflection. And I don't think Brian Elliott, I know, I'm just speaking from my personal experience, wouldn't want to leave this net at all. It does enable Jordan Binnington, the 22-year-old, who has been terrific the last year and a half in the American Hockey League Chicago Wolves. That's the one that I would give as well. Just, you know, you just don't want to leave it. He's the one that's been keeping this team in the game.
Wild right back on the attack again with Zucker. Zucker on the backhand scores! And it's 5-0 Minnesota.
And the deluge continues for Roberto Luongo in this building. Just can't catch a break at XL Energy Center. And what a nice transition here. Dumba, after the play broken up, just throws it into a lane because he knows that Zucker's got the speed to catch up with it. And not only does he catch up with it, he outlegs the defender, improves his angle to the top of the crease and beats Luongo. And I think that's it for Luongo. You will now see Reimer step into the game.
It for Luongo's stick. He just chunked it down the tunnel. So Reimer will take his place.
It could be it for the rest of his equipment too. And if you play it long enough, you're going to have one of these, or two of these, or in some guy's case, many more. And lucky he didn't light up one of his own players on the bench there.
Orbic cycles it back, and Johansson is there. He turns the puck over. Montreal feeds it out in front for Fleischman. Curls back to the line, across to Bartley. Bartley back over to Barbario. His bouncing shot, rebound, scores! Fleischman finds the top shelf, and the Montreal Canadiens have opened up a 3-goal lead in Washington.
And that's going to be it for Braden Holtby. Grubauer over the boards. And the march to pass Marty Brodeur is going to take a rope speed bump here. Holtby not happy at all leaving the crease.
3 goals on 18 shots. Holtby's night is over.
He's hot right now. He is going to smash something real quick. Here he goes.
He just might wait until he gets down.
No, he was just about to.
He's rearranging things right now. I can see it from where I'm sitting. So he is done. Philip Grubauer comes in, a guy who's done a nice job as a backup here.
Shots are 25-9. The big line for Nashville's out, trying to change the momentum. Fisher, Neal, Wilson with Josi and Weber, but it's a 2-on-1. Patrick Marleau back from Couture, scores! First Thornton, now Marlowe. And isn't that fitting for San Jose on this night?
When you're behind, you have to take risks. Nashville does here. Pinching in, Roman Josi. Or pardon me, with Shea Weber with the hit. The Sharks get the puck out of the zone. Here's the hit. Here's the odd man rush. And how about unselfish? Marlowe started it. Couture got it back to Marlowe. And what a shot. And again, hardly a chance for Pecorine. And there's what he's going through. And the change of goaltenders for Nashville.
Brilliant in his first game seven, and hard to put any of this on him tonight.
Looking for a pass and he gets it. Letestu catching up, winding and firing. Rebound, Letestu scores! Mark Letestu driving to the net, got the rebound. And the Oilers have opened up a two-goal lead.
This is textbook. We've been talking about this for a long time because the coaches have been talking about this to their players for a long time. Use the goalie to thump the pads to pass it to your line mate. Mike Camilleri does a great job. Check out the shot to the far pad, on the ice, kicked right to Mark Letestu, who knows exactly where the puck is going. He knows where the shot's going, so he can drive the net. Drives the net hard, gets the stick on the ice. The defenseman, he's got to take his man. He can't turn and find the puck, but he can't stop. Mark Letestu's got the head up, the steam. A big goal for the Edmonton Oilers. I think they might be having a look at this on the bench, but that one looked clean, but Mark Letestu in his 500th game puts the Oilers up by two in the second.
He gets his first even strength goal of the year.
Goalie change.
And Jimmy Howard is being replaced by Peter Mrazek.
I'm surprised actually at this, but it might be this by Jeff Blashill. And boy, Jimmy Howard just said something to Jeff Blashill as he was coming off the ice. He was not happy about getting yanked.
You know, I don't know if the coach saw this or not, but Robin Leonard during the TV timeout goes over to the bench. Watch this. A little wave to the fan. That's okay, I guess, but got a selfie. And then goal goes in and he goes back to the bench. And here he is chirping at the coach, going after him. A little bit hot afterwards. Oh. No more waves. No more waves going on now.
7:25 to go in the second period. She'll drink to that.
Burakovsky, bad angle wrister at 5:37. Beagle score! The Caps peppering the St. Louis Cage to the tune of 2-0.
And with the Beagle goal, the St. Louis Blues will be making a goalie change.
Warning about his game and how much development he's had this season alone. And he talked about the thing offensively that he wanted to work on the most.
Jake Allen has returned to the goal crease for the Blues during that timeout.
So right here, if he would have taken this mask off and gone down the hallway, he would not have gotten into the game as far as I'm concerned. I think by him staying in there and he kept trying to get the attention of the head coach, Ken Hitchcock, and Ken Hitchcock's looking. Is he into this? Is he gonna stay with me here? And he does. And Jake Allen, then the next whistle. So it wasn't the whistle following him getting pulled. It was the next stoppage of play. And there's the decision that Ken Hitchcock looks over and puts him back in the net.
Backstrom on the head man for Ovechkin. Steps to the middle, leaves. Backstrom one more. Oshie backhand. He scores! T.J. Oshie.
And now Connolly in. Gunnarsson blew a tire. And he scores! Brett Connolly. And it's 4-1 as Gunnarsson fell down.
Connolly has loads of speed through the neutral zone, and you're right, Carl Gunnarsson blew a tire, and we will have our second goaltending change in this game. The right-handed shot, Connolly is holding the puck out to the outside, and he brings it back into the middle, and as he's doing so, Jake blends with him and unable to make that save off the break.